there's a disturbing pattern of COVID-19 disparities that are occurring, particularly in communities of color and the others that have similar social deprivations, in which particularly amongst African Americans and Latinos, American Indians, there's a 4 to 5-fold increased risk of hospitalizations and unfortunately deaths related to COVID-19. So this is a critically important problem. And it relates to two major factors. One is the higher exposure of individuals from these communities to the virus that reflects the social determinants of health, the notion that they tend to work in service sector with greater contact with the public and the greater community spread opportunities of the pandemic. Similarly, we know that there are chronic disease risk factors that predispose to complications of COVID-19 that are highly prevalent in these same communities of color, such as diabetes, obesity, high blood pressure, cardiovascular disease. And so it's convergence and confluence of factors that has led to this disproportionate burden. So really the challenge is, what can we do to address these health inequities that reflect the effects of a legacy of structural racism and health inequities that have been reified and amplified in this context? And it really comes back to the NIH digging deeper in our health disparities research portfolio with a particular focus on two elements. One, the therapeutic trials and vaccine trials as part of our clinical research portfolio to see what we can do to prevent, treat, and eventually fight against and eliminate this pandemic through new treatment strategies and the vaccine, and ensuring that the clinical trials that are being conducted are diverse and inclusive and reflective not only of our country diversity, but also those communities that are most adversely affected. We believe that it is likely that if we are inclusive in our approach to finding solutions that are safe and effective, that then we can pivot to the process of implementation and dissemination of these effective therapies and prevention through vaccines in these same high-risk communities. And so it's critical that we have a full-court press effort for inclusion of these communities in clinical trials to test these agents and eventually get them once we know they're beneficial and share in that benefit. It's critical that we acknowledge and understand that there is a fair amount of misinformation there, as well as mistrust that has some legitimate historical roots. And we must address that heads on and engage communities and particularly their trusted partners and messengers in this fight to ensure that we have a bi-directional dialogue and ensure mutual benefit based on mutual respect in solving this problem. Toward that end, NIH, under the direction of the NIH director, Francis Collins, charged us to co-chair this with Dr. Eliseo Perez-Tabla and the Minority Health Institute as part of a trans-NIH effort called SEAL, Community Engagement Alliance Against COVID-19 Disparities, where we're funding a number of what we call SEAL teams at across various states that have the highest proportion of COVID-19, as well as a high concentration of these community of color, communities of color that are most adversely affected, and doing so in a way that they will work with trusted partners at the community level to reach them where they are, and address with contextual messages and trusted messengers the information they need to protect their families, their communities. And these groups will form coalitions that span from community-based organizations, our historically Black colleges and universities, the professional societies, professional organizations, as well as academia, in coalitions with community-based organizations to address the needs of these same communities and formulate new strategies that can then designed to reduce these health inequities in COVID-19.